Hello, and welcome back, everyone. AnthWolf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic. Playing as Venton Koliss, our Jedi Knight here. And where we last left off, we were doing an interlude video where we did the Flashpoint, also known as Mandalorian Raiders. Forgive me, actually, I'm still coming down with a bit of a cold. I thought it was clearing up. but not quite. I'm going to see myself there. I can see myself muting the video now and again. Bloody hell. Either way, that is not related to the video game. Right, so, yeah, we have Carrick Station. Most of the Republic fleet in the background there. And it looks like we're on our way to Tatooine to find one of these other Republic research projects and Master QX. Let's see, we have a couple of bits of mail. I mean, we just recently came back from speaking to the Jedi Council, but in regards to Akko Domi, he's getting some treatment, both of body and of the spirit. He continues to profess he is beyond redemption, but she believes that the true Akko is not lost to them forever. And, oh, Agent Galen. When he left Nar Shaddai, he wanted to die. He couldn't live with what Lord Sadik had done to him. When he's learned to bear the pain of what's been done, his transformation. SAS are sending him on a special assignment. Deep behind Imperial lines. Oh shit. Sounds like he's not going to be coming back from that mission either. He says he might not survive, which means he might, but... I wish him luck. Either way, is anything happening here? Oh, we have a few new operations. We'll maybe look at doing them in the future. For now, though, let's get ourselves over to the Outer Rim. Okay, what do we know about Tatooine? A harsh desert planet off the major trade routes, Tatooine is known for its heat, its sand, its dangerous wildlife, and very little else. Only a few settlements dot Tatooine's endless wastes, inhabited by handfuls of traders and moisture farmers. Tatooine's obscurity has also attracted a small but significant criminal population here to hide from galactic authorities. Tatooine lacks any central government or allegiance to the Republic or Empire. There are rumors of an Imperial occupation taking place in one of the frontier settlements, but nothing has been confirmed. Well, take it from me, it is confirmed. There are two spaceports on Tatooine that we know of. One in Anchorhead, which is I think the one we're going to be arriving at, and another in Mos Eila, which if you're playing as a member of the Empire, where you will be turning up. For whatever reason you are here on this world. We're normally meant to come here at level 24 to 28. We've overshot that by a wide margin, but what can you do? Okay, let's be on our way.
General, I'm on Tatooine. Has Master Kuix reported in?
Last we heard, Kuix secured our weapons research facility. She's missed every comm check since then. Enemy action is the most likely scenario, but on Tatooine, anything's possible.
If it's so dangerous, why pick it for your weapons facility?
Tatooine has millions of uninhabited kilometers, perfect for our research. Dr. Godera will brief you on the weapons project. Doctor?
The research facility on Tatooine has created a device codenamed the Shock Drum. The weapon discharges massive ultrasonic vibrations into the ground. It damages enemy fortifications at a microscopic level, quite literally softening them up. The vibrations will cripple people if they're close enough. But that's not all. The shock drum eventually disrupts the planetary core. At critical mass, the core explodes.
Were you planning to destroy Tatooine?
Of course not. When we discovered this potential, we immediately stopped testing. However, there's a fully operational shock drum prototype at our facility. If Darth Angrel has captured it, the results will be catastrophic. With no word from the facility or Master Koix, we must assume the worst.
I sense Master Koix through the Force, but it's faint. I think she's dying.
Can you feel her surroundings? Where is she?
Not sure. Somewhere dark. It's taking everything she has to stay alive.
I don't have any Republic contacts there to assist you. You're on your own. Our facility is located in a remote part of the desert. I'm transmitting the coordinates. Good luck. Varsuthra, out.
Okay. Get ourselves down to the spaceport. So we have, apart from the location of the research lab, which I suppose is something important, we have no support here whatsoever. Along for this mission, since our T7 was rather apprehensive about going next to something that can destroy his chassis. Ultrasonic vibrations. Alright. So we'll get outside of Anchorhead Spaceport and see who wishes to have a word. As I think the facility is actually out in the desert. Oh. Excuse me, sneezing away. Have a droid there that would like our attention. So yeah. We have Anchorhead Spaceport. We have a transport service droid taxi service over here. We have a marketplace, a cantina. And over somewhere that way is Sandcrawler. And yeah, we need to head deep in the jungle to find the research facility. Okay. We'll be going out there eventually, but not quite yet. Let's see how we can help people here in Anchorhead first.
Hi, sorry to interrupt. My name's Fowler. I was told you might be passing through. I represent the Republic here. Since we don't get many Jedi, I thought we could meet. I think we should talk. Get my meaning?
Speak your mind. Just make it quick.
Here's the thing. I'd rather not do this by holocommunicator. I've got a little, embassy in downtown Anchorhead. Swing on by. I promise you it's worthwhile.
I can't commit to this, but I'll see what I can do.
Good to hear it. The sooner the better. This is much bigger than some local trouble. Fowler out.
So a very vague communication. We have all our heroic mission terminal there. And we have a sheriff. Yeah, that's it. There is nowhere. There's not even Imperial security here. Never mind Republic security. This is all pretty pioneer stuff here on Tatooine.
Morning, Master Jedi. Now, I'm not going to beat around the bush. We need help, and I'm hoping you can provide it. The Twin Suns pirates think they can get away with murder, and usually do. But now, they're selling our people as slaves, and we won't stand for it.
You have my complete attention.
We don't know where they're holding the slaves, but we have uncovered a different Twin Suns operation. Old Zerka droids. They're smuggling them off-planet by way of a warehouse outside Anchorhead. I figure that's the place to start looking for anything more.
Any other relevant information about this place?
They guard the warehouse pretty heavily. Some of the thugs there are sure to know what the other side of their operation is doing. Search any communications you find. See if you can follow the trail to uncover their slaving operation. The children of Anchorhead are counting on you.
Okay. There was some disturbance going on behind me there as well. Oh well. So, the Republic Embassy, Fowler, has told us to head right up here. And this is also where the old Zerka droids are being placed before they're shipped off-world. I think there's a few more missions in the cantina. So let's get ourselves over there, have a look around. See a datacron in the distance, with sort of slight glow. And here's the cantina. There's two entrances, of course. There's one just around this corner. Wanna pop in? I'd say there's definitely a couple of missions in there we would like to pick up, but first things first. Right. So you have these Twin Suns.
Lightsaber jerk!
We know the rendezvous coordinates now. We just need to find a signaling device. Awesome. Okay. Think we need. Seal ourselves up slightly. We have been poisoned, but we need to find this Twin Sun contact actually in the cantina itself.
Spikeheads are on the prowl again.
Sand people?
No mistaking them. Marching across the Junlin Wastes, testing our borders.
They'll never move on Anchorhead.
Better hope not. Lost my son to those savages. Didn't stand a chance.
Well, we heard about another native species. The Sand People, also known as the Tuscan Raiders. Or, I suppose, Tuscans, to maybe themselves. Yeah. various people would like our attention, but for now...
Your Shinax? I hear you're selling slaves for the Twin Sons.
Yinga yinga kijita, nimni tanuv, alelo kwekuta. Chobot I kafstuan, dile jihulo kuta.
Local security is already involved. Encott sent me personally. I suggest you cooperate.
Mistuka mogoto parchi chisa domba, kupa tonti toki maki chisa chubolo wawuni.
So this guy, this contact, openly admits to selling slaves because seemingly it's legal here on Tatooine. Probably because there's no bloody, real government. Anything's legal. But since we told him that, whatever amounts for local security is now involved, he's quite willing to make another deal. Ah, bugger. I go up this way. Slaves are in Hangar 21. Probably under Twin Sun Guard. Deal with the kidnappers and the slave master, as well as rescue any slaves we find.
Lightsaber jerk.
We have a bonus to defeat 15 members of the Twin Sons here in the Hangar Bay. Slave master. Back to the far side of the hangar to finish off the bonus mission. days. Our health's looking a little ropey, but... Yep, slaves rescued. Good deed done for the day. Go let the sheriff know that some Republic citizens are not going to be transported off-world against their will once again. And then I guess we'll head back over to the cantina.
Slaves are free.
I know. We've had some make their way back here. And they're telling everyone how one man took out all the twin sons. I'll send some of the militia boys to hold that hangar the sons were working out of. We'll make sure no one starts that sort of thing up again. On behalf of the free men of Tatooine, I thank you.
Okay. Happy days, plenty of experience. Right. Back to the cantina once again. So there was an exploration mission and a heroic mission down there. In addition, just outside the back entrance, there was actually a side mission available. That side mission used to actually be down on the lower level of the cantina as well, but they've moved him for one reason or another.
Is everything okay? You look like something's bothering you.
Ogenekunk, toleras ege mas funales. Folio semisem, ugenezet ki. Ege fat iol, zero es sugarzo.
What makes you think that?
Seche bentex du raso, zo kis zal. Eves tob ere ni as igrit. Saka homa niomasto alat elere.
You have my word. It will be done.
Megfenta parton hoje es futot ki a tengere. As urig fico had mert aki sok. Seche bentex du raso, zo kis zal.
Okay, so there's a Mandalorian clan here causing problems, trying to take over Anchorhead. That is, oh, just to the south, okay. We've helped the sheriff, we have a constable here as well.
Kabanotase makipuna, malituta udmishka. Joto gekwanga chuska, nucha kichawa.
Can you explain that?
Kabanotase makipuna, malituta udmishka. Chaskruni dopat kurira, dokanki kun.
Where would you suggest I start?
Tauz azulus uvaltung mi chakulka dimaji. Nigtori na natuta, ta aitawanawanga na chuba. Patoga wata kiko uva kiri wata buki donko.
Okay, so someone's doing a bit of a thievery around Anchorhead. The only link we have is that some astromech droids are seen around the scene before it takes place. So we can find and disable them. See if we can find out where they're being controlled from. Or who's giving them commands. We might be able to find our thief. Now, before we do that though. Now this individual who is trying not so subtly to not look in our direction.
What's with the weapons? Expecting an attack? Why can't your client tell me about this? You have my word. It will be done.
Okay, so that client, obviously Neb is the bodyguard, is supplying water evaporators on the cheap to the locals. And the local crime lords aren't best pleased with that act of charity. Astromech droids.
Lightsaber jerk.
Do you have what I need? You do. Perfect. And while we're here, somewhere, Neb, the bodyguard, give us his client's ID card. Trying to, lure out the assassins, making them think we are the client. Some assassins, but seemingly there is a whole bunch of them in the Western Warehouse. Dealing with that one group isn't enough. Few of the assassins and locate their Ultra Commander.
Break your record, boss.
The Ultra Commando is upstairs. Go this way, we cannot.
can hopefully give reason for the assassins to pause. Try to track down who is performing these thefts around Anchorhead. According to the tracker, it's just outside the city. Here's our first encounter with a Jawa.
Somebody needs to tell the Jawas that tooling around in a giant vehicle doesn't help them look any bigger. Still, it's a nice ride.
There are droids stealing holocams from Anchorhead. I trace their control signal here.
Bahonkabi, Shawanawanki. Miskakaji. Edwana Urbi Kilawato Bunky, don't go up to Canada.
Do the right thing next time, or I'll be back.
Yuna Rishka Chanagawa, Chi, Caspina Contrinka. Mo Gutuni Ompi, Bedwana, Nipopo, Chopoma.
Kira's just kind of frowning at us. Was that a threat? Hey, if it stops him from thieving. After all, we only used our words, we didn't actually pull out our lightsaber. I think he got off rather lightly there. Go speak to Neb, let him know that his client may be safe, but best err on the side of caution just in case. More assassins could always be hired, of course.
Your client is safe now. I think I've flushed all of the assassins.
All these relics, none of them are really useful for us right now. Let the constable know what we discovered.
Tuni Rana Nuprata Dunko?
There was a Jawa controlling the droids remotely. He was responsible for stealing the holocams, but I got them back.
Kuchusa Yomata Chitoya? Nam Kanoya Choski Nawi? O Grani Tampio da Pushiwumpa? Pu Tula Musta?
Okay, happy days. Right, let's go look into these Mandalorians making this siege-proof bunker. Defeat 12 Mandalorians, their War Master. I think there's a bonus to deal with Mandalorian weapon shipments as well. From the top of my head, but we'll have a look. See what we can find. What's over here? Munitions, there you go. Oh my God. Now, we shouldn't need to go down this way for any reason. The War Master's along. Yeah, along past this specialist. Let's keep our health topped up for now. Nervous to force leap on him in case I aggroed this other group. And then I saw my health go, wow, ooh, 0% health for a moment. I think we had like 300 remaining. Ouch. Yeah, let's slow it down just a little. Munitions over there, but there's bound to be two more munitions in the final room, which is where we'll find the War Master. It's a fairly straightforward heroic mission, actually. Not very big, just very. It's more compact, which is a problem when there's multiple players trying to do the same objective. Because I think these Mandalorians have a bit of a respawn time. Alright, munitions. There's a giant security chest over there. Tends to have more goodies. Okay, there's some munitions over there. Right, okay. And there's the War Master. Ourselves up. Ah, happy days. I'll take the pummeler's gear. See what we find. A new power relic. Okay. Ouch. Okay, and that's us pretty much done here at Anchorhead. Might as well just quick travel to the Anchorhead Cantina, and then go see this representative Fowler. Seemingly, this is the Republic Embassy. While we wait, maybe you, and probably you. Modify companion lightsabers. There you go. I mean, the yellow crystal's fine as well, of course. Ready to go. Oh, what's going on here?
Leave me alone! I haven't done anything to you!
You stole corporate documents, Camus. Zerka doesn't take industrial sabotage lightly.
Contact. Subject is a Jedi. What are your orders, sir?
You know the drill. No survivors, no leaks.
You're not killing anyone here.
Open fire!
Nope. Oh, well.
Down.
Would you mind explaining what all that was about?
Is it safe? Are they dead?
Why were those people attacking us?
It's... Well, they were... Sorry, I've got to... Just keep breathing. Okay. My name is Camus Orden. I used to be an accountant. My company sent those men to kill me. It's a Zerka Corporation severance package.
What happened in here? Come on, Camus. You know how I feel about corpses in my workspace.
You were supposed to be here. You swore I'd be protected.
Sorry, Camus. As an official Republic representative, I have to at least look like I'm being diplomatic with the locals.
You're the man I spoke to earlier. Care to explain?
Huh. I take it you saved Camus? Thanks. You're probably catching on that we're a bit understaffed, and that I'm not really a bureaucrat.
It took you a month to tell me that.
This is a Republic Strategic Information Service project, a covert operation. It's a major assignment. Mystery, corporate scandal, and incredibly dangerous tech, with a lot of lives on the line. You could make all the difference.
I hope the Strategic Information Service doesn't plan to keep me in the dark.
Sorry. Old habits are hard to break. This all started when Camus forwarded some Zerka Corporation documents to his local Republic security office. Now, we've been watching Zerka a while. They buried a lot of scandals, done a lot of dirty deals, but this was something special.
The documents were mixed in with old expense reports. They described a billion-credit research facility for the study of a Type 7 device.
Type 7 device being Zerka shorthand for a device capable of eliminating a planetary population.
A corporation has a weapon that can destroy a planet?
Destroy a planet, or maybe just kill everyone on it. Makes a difference to the right kind of megalomaniac. Turns out they abandoned the project decades ago. We're lucky to know the facility was here on Tatooine. So Camus and I came to find whatever doomsday device Zerka had and keep them from burying the evidence. And us.
Why would Zerka leave behind such an expensive project?
From what we could find, sounds like the device went haywire, and Zerka bailed rather than try and clean it up. Now, clues to Zerka's operation have been extremely hard to come by. Impossible, as a matter of fact. We've got one avenue left, but it's too dangerous for Camus or me. An old compound Zerka used as a staging area.
What's in the compound?
After Zerka left, the compound was taken over by a gang of Gamorrean raiders who, I discovered, don't appreciate visitors. Still, judging by these dead guys here, you might be able to push past the Gamorreans and search Zerka's old storage archives. Gather any data left.
Sounds like this should be relatively simple.
Be careful. Finding the files that Zerka left in that compound is important, but don't get killed.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Yeah, getting killed would be a hamper on our situation. Okay. So, speaking of doomsday weapons, there's not one on this planet, there's at least two. At least we know about a shock drum. But seemingly Zerka Corporation had something in their hands. And then for some reason abandoned it years ago. Unfortunately, this is not actually an Anchorhead. The old Zerka compound is out in Junland once again. But we'll pop over there briefly. I mean, there's a few things we need to do in that region, but we can leave the rest until maybe the next video, when we're going to be in that area for a much longer period of time. Okay.
Vehicle pads are currently open for business. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
You'd think you might be able to travel to Junland just via your speeder, but there are areas here on Tatooine known as Deep Desert where you start just taking damage over time due to hydration issues, if nothing else. So you need to take these transport service droids to take these speeders to get about. So here's our forward base of operations. What do they call it? Dreviad Outpost. There's a couple of people who would like our attention. and to the north is the shock drum research facility. As I say, we'll check that out later. Oh, similar to the astromech droid on Coruscant, who would tell us about Hammer Station. We have one that would tell us about Mandalorian raiders if we hadn't actually just sorted out that situation. When we next come to Junland, I'll probably switch over to the PvP instance. I don't believe we'll encounter any members of the Empire in Junland, but from now on, if a world would allow us to encounter someone from the other faction, we will be engaging them in combat, which there's a chance that it might happen. It'll more likely happen, if anywhere, in the Dune Sea, though that is quite large an area. Or it may also occur on Alderaan when we get there, because Alderaan is still a fairly large world to explore, but it's a bit more enclosed. Players of the Republic and the Empire do travel along the same routes, so to speak. Right. Zerka facility. Ooh. They've even managed to get some of the droids up and running.
Who's incremental? Pull out on a day's notice and leave a nice big base for the bad guys to move into.
Seems like there's something happening in the next room, but first things first. Speaking of, level 48, we gained a level, but we gained a new passive on our discipline tree. We have Robust. Full sleep grants Robust, providing immunity to interrupts, stuns, knockdowns, and incapacitating effects for 4 seconds. Initially during this time, damage reduction is also increased by 20%. So that's actually going to be really good. Combine that with Unremitting at level 51 to stop us from being affected from movement impairing effects, we should be able to initiate combat rather than be nervous that we're going to jump into someone and they're going to knock us out or stun us in some way. Alright, let's heal ourselves up. Some more Circa Corporation individuals here.
So what do you say? Do we have a deal? Marvelous. I have absolutely no idea what you just said, my indelicate friend, but marvelous.
Sir, intruders!
Well, you don't look like you're part of Shurg's little Gamorrean clan.
Are you with Zerka Corporation?
Oh, indeed. So let me guess. You're here because of Camus, hmm? That little rat does know how to squeak. Of course, I can't have you interrupting my deal. I'd murder you myself, but that's just not possible right now.
Who are you? What are you?
Well, that's a bit personal. Maybe another time. The rest of you can deal with this interruption. I'll be in touch later.
Oh, great. Seems Circa were after the same files we were. You'd think Circa would already have all the information. But since they abandoned the project, whatever it is, maybe they didn't take any files with them. Right, we just need to get ourselves back over. Let me double check, actually. Yeah, we need to get ourselves back over to the embassy. So, that's our brief foray into Jundland for now. Is very slowly rising. Anything else of interest? So level 51 for our next utility skill, level 52 for our next passive bonus. Okay.
I'll feel a lot better when we change bases, Fowler. I don't like this.
You say that now, but just wait until you see the real desert. Hey, look who's back and alive. You able to find anything?
I found your data, along with Gamorreans and a Zerka strike team.
Blast. Guess they must be one step ahead of us.
Master Fowler? It looks like there's a call coming in.
Why, hello, everyone. Master Fowler, Master Orden. And my little visitor from the Gamorrean hideout. Especially nice to see you again. You're doing well, I hope.
Be direct. Tell me what it is you want.
Since I didn't get the chance before, I thought I'd formally introduce myself. I am Gaim Lexende, here on behalf of Zerka Corporation.
I know that name.
I understand that the Republic is disputing Zerka's property rights. I've come to Tatooine to retrieve our belongings, including Camus Orden.
You're after more than an accountant.
Perhaps, but one has to start somewhere. Zerka will take any actions necessary to protect its interests. And I assure you, our representatives in the Senate can excuse any incidents.
Lexende. They say he's the son of an executive. He's supposed to run the company's special enforcement branch.
Rich boy who took up wet works as a hobby. Up to his neck in cybernetics. Good news is, Zerka wouldn't have sent him if we were on the wrong track. He wants to keep us from the old facility. Look, Camus and I could use some time to review this data, but I still need you. If you're heading into the desert, give me a call.
You expect to find something out there?
I have suspicions. Hoping these files will confirm them. You can reach me from a secure line at one of the militia bases. We'll talk soon.
Okay. Carbon scored armor set. Interesting. What level is this gear? Not very good. Fair enough. Okay. We'll wind things down. What we'll do is we'll get ourselves back over to Dreviad Outpost, and then we'll take a break. But when we come back, we'll be looking to explore Junland a bit more in depth. I see there's a few people there who would like to gain our assistance, and of course, that's also where the Shock Drum facility happens to be. But, as I say, it's going to be winding down now. There's nothing really new that we're going to be doing. Well, yeah, we're going to be switching over to, if we can, depending on the worlds we're visiting, switching over to the PvP instance. I mean, I don't expect that I'll encounter any other players, especially from the Sith Empire. But you never know. And if we encounter them, and, well, whether we win or lose, it adds a little bit more interest to the series, I think. If there's a chance that we could be jumped on suddenly and killed. I think when we were playing as... When I was playing as my Sith Warrior in the replay of the Sith Warrior series, we only really encountered one other player from the other faction, and that was in the Rise of the Hutt Cartel expansion.
Vehicle pads are currently open for business.
I think it was a trooper as well. Either way, yeah, Dreviad Outpost is where Fowler, the SAS agent, would like us to contact him as well. He has a holo terminal just outside of the main building you can see in the distance there, which I think happens to be another cantina. But for now, so we'll get ourselves parked. Thank you all for joining me here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic. I've of course been AnthWolf, and hopefully I'll see you for even more next time. But until then, enjoy the rest of your day. Take care now. Bye-bye now.